Hey guys, what's going on? Tyler here. Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, I want to talk about the iPad Air that Apple just announced last week, the iPad Air, the fourth generation. And so I want to compare it to the iPad Air I currently have, which is the third generation, and the current generation of iPad Pro. And so the iPad Air I have now, I'm just going to go over some specs just in general, just so you have a better idea of the comparison here. The iPad Air I have now has a 10.5 inch screen, it has an A12 chip, and it can record 1080p video, and it has two speakers on it, and it can handle 4K video and it can handle 1080p video without any issues at all. This is key to my workflow, to my video production. I use it for ideas, writing down ideas, to sometimes editing pictures, thumbnails, video, all kinds of stuff. And so the new iPad Air, the fourth generation, has a 10.9 inch display. It uses the Apple Pencil second generation. This uses the Apple Pencil, the first generation of it. It has an A14 Bionic chip. It uses USB-C, and that's really good because it can connect straight to monitors, right to cameras, storage devices, anything that uses USB-C. Why do I want to keep calling it UBS? It has Touch ID within the power button. It does not have a home button anymore, and I like Touch ID better than Face ID, so I'm a big fan of that. And overall, it's just a lot more powerful than the current generation iPad Air. But if you look at the current generation of iPad Pro, it looks like the new iPad Air is more powerful than the Pro. And so the iPad Pro has an A12Z chip, but it does have a better display, more cameras and better cameras. It has four speakers, which is better than just two. And then it uses Face ID, which for some people is a better thing than Touch ID. The iPad Air that just got announced is more powerful CPU-wise than the iPad Pro. So, if you are looking at these iPads and you're wondering what iPad should I get for my video production, this is still a great choice, the iPad Air third generation. I have some videos that I've done showing that you can edit video on here, both the 4K and the 1080p, and I'll show some of that and I'll link them. And it's completely capable of that. But if you're really digging the iPad Air, the new design, the new chip that it has in it, and you have the money to spend and you don't have an iPad Air to begin with, I would definitely consider this fourth generation of iPad Air. And I can't lie, I looked at this, I was like, man, it'd be really nice to have one, but I'm happy with the iPad I have now, and I will use this. Now, you know, a couple months down the road, that may change, but well, for now, we're sticking with this. And so the new iPad Air has a starting price of $599. That's $100 more than the starting price of the previous generation. Still starts at 64 gigabytes, which I think is an insult. If you're going to use this a lot for producing media and consuming media, I think you should bump up to the 256 gigabyte storage size. And the interesting thing is, like, this is just crazy. The iPad Air starts at $599. The iPad Pro is $999. That's $400 more. And really the only thing different that you're getting that's better is the display, cameras, and speakers. If that stuff's not super important to you, it's a no-brainer. For $400 less, you can have the iPad Air with a better chip. Yes, please, sign me up. I'm just looking at this stuff and I'm thinking, man, this iPad Air is just awesome. Just from knowing what the third generation's like, I would 100% recommend it for video production. And even just production of anything, really. Photos, spreadsheets. It is completely capable, especially with a keyboard. You can get the smart keyboard with it, with a smart keyboard folio, and it's just a really, really good device. And in my opinion, there's no other tablet that comes close to the iPads. Samsung can try to do their thing, and Chromebook or whatever. No, just forget all that stuff. The iPad has the best app support. It has the best support overall for peripherals, for cases, and it is the go-to tablet if you want a powerful mobile setup for running a business, video production, photo editing, any of that stuff. The iPad Air or the iPad line in general is the way to go. And so let me know what you guys think about the iPad Air. Do you think that you're going to be buying it? Are you going to use it for video production? Are you just going to use it because you want an iPad? That's perfectly acceptable. Or do you have an idea for it for something else? Let me know down in the comment section below. Let me know what you think about it. And if you did enjoy this video, make sure you hit the thumbs up button and also subscribe for more videos from me. Doing videos about video production, camera and audio gear, YouTube, all this stuff. And if that interests you, make sure you subscribe and stay tuned for more videos. All my social links are down in the description below, as well as this lower third that should be here somewhere. And that's going to be it for this one. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.